Hello and greetings from Iceland. This video is all about the land rise on the Reykjavik Peninsula, since the magma is getting closer. It was at 16 km depth in my last update, but today it's about 10 km down to the magma. And the speed of the land rise has been increasing. So here we go again. It looks as the next eruption, eruption number 4, is underway. Meaning that I'm putting my channel into hot mode. And the guessing game is about to start. Or where the red stuff is going to come up this time, and how much of it. And let's start this with the insert picture that was published today, Friday. Those are the three lava fields from the first three eruptions, and it was a bit of a surprise to see how widespread it is. And the epicenter seems to be around here, by the west side of Mount Faradalsfjall. This can also be seen through the GPS system, so I'm leaving a link to the many stations that they have around there. And I did actually expect to see land rise by the dike that fed the first three eruptions, especially between the mountain Little Hrútur, where the last eruption took place, and the mountain Keilir, where experts expected a separate fissure to open up during the last eruption, but according to this, the land seems to have subsided around there, but overall it is too early to make any rock solid predictions. But it is, however, a rock solid fact that in the last 2-3 days especially, a large number of earthquakes have been detected around here, or by the southernmost part of the dike that fed the first eruption. So let's move to drone angle from here. I remember clearly good number of earthquakes around there during and after the 2021 eruption. So there was some magma on the move there during that time. And right now, this is the soft spot, but we know how it goes now. Tomorrow, the magma might be doing some tunneling elsewhere, looking for the weakest spot in the crust. And then, one of those days, we will get a magnitude 4 plus earthquake and the magma takes off like a racehorse. Through whatever channel it can find or make. And the countdown starts to the next eruption. And when the magma is at 3-5 km depth from the surface, that's when the guessing game starts for real. And when we think about the location, I've said it before. Mother Earth has already picked the best spots 3 times in a row. We just can't get more lucky than that. So I'm a bit worried about this bulge in the ground that is west of Mount Faradalsfjall. Since if the eruption were to come up on that side of the mountain, it is putting a part of the town at risk. But then, it can be just a matter of meters from where it comes up or where it will flow. Like the last eruption in July, if it would have occurred around 500 meters further north, the lava would have flowed to the north, but not to the south like it did. But in that case, the eruption didn't take that long time, so it didn't matter. But if the next eruption comes up on Mount Faradalsfjall like eruption number 1, we might have to work on the barriers again, or to see if it could be possible to control the flow in some way. And the civil defense has actually designed barriers around the town, but we hope that we will never have to build them. But again, it's just too early to say. I'm just saying now that we are in stage 2. Stage 3 is when the stronger earthquakes start. That's the hard part for the people who live on the peninsula and Reykjavik. And the biggest question is, of course, when? So, like I stated in a recent video, the time from confirmed magma intrusion until the fire comes up is getting shorter due to how fractured the ground is already. And my wild guess without any responsibility would be even early November. So it is a good reason to keep an eye on the seismometers now. And we have to keep in mind that the build-up to this eruption started even before the last eruption came to an end. And as for me and the channel, I will of course be ready. I did arrive at the location around 14 hours before eruption number 2 and 4 or 5 days before eruption number 3. I live around 400 kilometers away. Still, I'm actually planning to move to Reykjavik, but as for the next eruption, I will do what I have to do to get some of the first images. And finally, I'm reminding you about my photo tour that I just got back from. It has it all. greasy, cheesy hot dogs, volcanoes, hot springs, and of course a drone crash. It's a never a dull moment while I do my tours, and with that I'm sending you best regards from the volcano island, Iceland.